Guys, just before we get into this video, a little disclaimer. This video is for educational purposes only and advice. If you guys aren't confident in doing your own wiring, don't play around with it. Things can go seriously wrong if you get things wrong. Go see a licensed auto sparky or an electrician. They'll be across all of this stuff. They do a trade, they're experts in it, and they'll be able to help you out.
Righto, guys, I'll have to apologize if you can't see this. I've lost a fair bit of light since I turned all the canopy lights off. Guys, what I've done, I've just taken it back to exactly how this thing comes fresh out of the box. So as you would have known from my other video, I'm not too impressed with how these things come out of the box. They're an absolute bird's nest out of the box. Something that you probably want to look at if you do have one of these units is tidying these cables so it's a bit easier to work on. But anyway. So straight out of the box, guys, you'll notice you have five terminal posts, one, two, three actives, and two negatives straight above. So you'll notice down here, there's another link between the two bottom active terminals. Now, all you have to do to make one Anderson plug dedicated to a solar input is disconnect this link and trace this cable back to what Anderson plug that goes to. Now that we know which Anderson plug is going to be our solar input and we know where the link is to take out, let's take the link out and then we'll show you what you do from there.
Righto, guys, so this is where I think some people might come a little bit unstuck. So after your link's been taken out, this is what you should be able to see. One terminal with two cables coming off it, one Anderson plug and one to your fuse block, and then one cable on the terminal post straight above, and that's just going off to an Anderson plug with nothing else connected to it. This terminal here is now your dedicated solar. So if you have a fixed panel on your roof, you can wire that back down to this post. Or if you have an Anderson plug that you want to plug into the front, like we're doing here, this is where that solar connection comes to. So when you add your MPPT or PW solar charger, your solar panel terminal wires to this post and your battery now wires to this post. Right, guys, so now when it comes to wiring in your solar charge controller, this is what we've done with our system. Now your system may be slightly different depending on what charge gear you have, but I'll show you. This is our cable for our solar panel, for our solar input, meaning the power coming from your solar panel. The cable just below it, you can see here is another, there's another red cable. That, in our case, is for our battery connection. So I'll wire this all back up, get it solar ready, and then I'll show you exactly what it should look like.
Righto, guys, so now that I've done the connections for making the unit solar ready, this is what you should have. Bottom terminal connects to your battery. One cable off to your Anderson plug for your fixed accessory in your car, whether that be a fridge or a travel buddy or whatever you want to run. Another cable connected to the same battery terminal post for your fuse block. That'll run off to the bottom side of your fuse block and supply that fuse block with power. Top terminal, we've now taken the link out. They're totally separate. One thick cable with a 50 amp fuse for an Anderson plug. PV cable for your charge controller. So this little cable here goes off to your solar charge controller and supplies your solar charge controller with solar power. Not battery power, solar power. This is the cable from your solar panel. Takes a little bit of imagination, but imagine this cable here is going back to a solar panel that you plug in on the other side. This cable down here that I've explained just a bit earlier, this cable is going off to the front of our unit, connecting to the bottom of our fuse block. This goes back to the battery terminal post on the other side.
Bit of a side note, guys. So for our install, you guys would know we have a fixed panel on the roof as well as a folding solar blanket. So I just thought I'd give you a quick little look at that. So this cable here, you can see it goes straight out the top of our control panel in a conduit. That goes up to our solar panel on the roof. So just to give you guys an idea, solar power goes in to this top terminal, goes off to our charger through this cable here, and then it comes back from the charger on this second red wire here, over to our fuse block, and then through the cable that it's connected to, runs back to the bottom terminal here and off to the battery. In a nutshell, guys, that's how it works. Now it's time to just put it all back together, give it a quick little test, and make sure everything's working the way we want it to. So all you have to do here is turn on our circuit breaker on, nothing tripped, that's always a good sign. Easiest way for me to tell these things is just turn on the lights. All of our lights are on.
Guys, depending on what setup you're running and what gear you've got in your installation, you might need further protection. You might need an extra circuit breaker, an extra fuse in line with some of your gear. Luckily for us, the Victron gear,
that I use in this setup has a 25 amp fuse on the secondary side, so charging the battery. We also run a 150 amp circuit breaker in line with our battery. It's the first thing off the battery. That's in case we want to add an inverter later on down the track. We've got cable good enough to handle 200 amps, and that 150 amp circuit breaker is just going to protect that cable. That's pretty much it, guys. That's pretty much how you make one of the Anderson plugs on your XDM control panel solar ready and dedicated to solar.